So let me ask you a question. When you are born, okay, when you were born, how many children were there born for your parents? We always think that I am only born. So we are not speaking of your brother and sisters. When you were born to your parents, how many children were born? You think you are one child which is born. In reality, there are three children. Can you see? First child is the human child. One cell from your father and one cell from your mother. Okay. Just one cell, your father and mother contributed one cell each. The one cell, the two cells became four cells. Four cells became eight, eight became 16, and you became a meatball. And the meatball started developing eyes somewhere, ears somewhere, nose somewhere. So you have a first child is the biological child, which is because of your parents. One cell from the mother, one cell from the father. Is it all? The biological child, okay? Biological child has contribution from your parents, only two cells. Imagine, now your body has billions of cells, trillions of cells. Your parents didn't contribute to that. And how proud you feel that I have, it's my child. In your child, for your child, your contribution is only two cells, my dear. And the two has become four, four has become eight. You didn't do that. Four, eight, 16. Who made that? That is the divine consciousness Shakti, the power of consciousness Shakti, the divine mother. She multiplied two cells into four, four into eight, eight into 16, and she fixed the eyes at this place, ears at this place, exactly where it is required. So that's why there's a poet called, there's a Sufi saint called Kahil Gibrail. He says, your children are not your children. They are the God's children. You are only providing a passage for the divine children to come to the earth. You are actually a gateway. You have a responsibility for the child, but you cannot own the child because they are God's children. So now you have to ask yourself how many children you have. So this is called human child. Okay, human child is because two cells from the mother, father and mother came into picture. That's called biological child. So then there's a divine child, which is consciousness got reflected there. This is Chidabhasa. The Chidabhasa got reflected in the mind. And once Chidabhasa got reflected, then they start developing the body. The two cells become four. The consciousness, the power of consciousness called Shakti. The intelligence started creating the whole body, building the whole body. So really, the divine mother is responsible for this. The two cells had a reflected consciousness. The reflected consciousness is Shiva. The universal consciousness got reflected as Chidabhasa. Atma got reflected as Chidabhasa in that body. So you are the second child. This is actually the first child. The first child has biological father and biological mother. The second child has divine father and divine mother. The Chidabhasa has the divine father, Atma. Okay, the body, which is actually from two cells, it became four cells, eight cells. That's because of the divine mother. So you have divine father and divine mother. In whole of this process, the biological parents only contribute two cells. And rest all is the contribution of divine father, divine mother, Shakti and Shiva. So they are divine parents. So then comes the third child. So you can see the hair has grown a little bit. Okay. So now, immediately after 13 days, the child is given a name. Papa, Chinnu, Guddu, Guddu. Okay. Some name is given to the child. So Papu, Papu. The child doesn't know it is itself. The child is innocent. Okay. So suddenly it gives a name. It doesn't know. Then every day mother comes and programs the child. You are that Papu. You are that Guddu. You are that Chinnu. Gradually the programming takes place. The mind starts growing. So the mind is the third child. Okay. And so there are first child is biological parents, two parents, father and mother. And then the divine father and divine mother, Shiva and Shakti. And the third child, which is actually contribution of society, mother, father, grandparents, TV, mobile phone, video games, school classmates, teacher, the school, the society, books, everything, and Puranas, Itihasas, religions, Pujaris, Pandits, everybody will come program this third child, the society child. Okay. So now there are three children. You thought you were only one? There are three. The biological child, the divine child, and the society child. The biological child has only two parents. They have just given two cells and they think they have done a big job. Okay. And then there is a divine child, divine mother and father who have done all other job. Building up your whole body, giving your eyes, fixing your ears, and then everything. Then the society child does all the spoiling. It programs you. Right? So there are three children. Divine child, the society child, and biological child. Now, if I ask you, who are your parents? What will you say? You'll happily say, biological parents. Without knowing that, they have just given two cells. Who are you really in this, out of these? Biological child, societal child, or divine child? What are you really? Okay. You think you are only the biological child. Biological child is just a two cells contribution from the parents. Really, you are the divine child, the consciousness, Chidabhasa, and the body built by Shakti. Your biological parents, mother, gives you, feeds you milk couple of months after you are born. After that, you have to eat. Okay. She will carry you for 9 months. After her responsibility ends. But the divine mother's responsibility, it doesn't end there. She takes care of you till you die. She will take, your eyes are functioning because of divine energy, Shakti. Your ears are functioning because of divine energy. Your tongue is functioning because of divine Shakti. Your heart is functioning. Your kidney is functioning. Your liver is functioning. You are able to talk, speak. Your brain is functioning. All because of divine mother Shakti. You don't even know how your brain is functioning. You don't know how tongue is talking. Okay. So biological mother job ends. Or rather, she will take care of you. Now biological mother job ends also, even if 35 years also, mama, mama, baby, mama will be there. But that is not there. She doesn't come and take care of you every day. Every second, every minute, when you are wake, when you are waking state or dream state or deep sleep state, the divine mother takes care of you, Shakti. In terms of prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. So five pranas, she takes care of you. The Shiva, the consciousness, divine father guards your consciousness. Chaitanya, Chidabhasa is present in you all the time. So who are you really? But you don't, if you, all the time you are the society child. If I ask you, who are you? You say, I am woman. Who told you are a woman? Because society. Okay. You say, I am wife. That is a society child. All our problems in life are the society child. The society child is the noisemaker. It's a cry baby. All you say, I have a problem. Who has a problem? The society child. And the society child problems are not your problems. These are society problems dumped on you. Okay, you say, I don't look smart. Why? My color skin is not fair. Who told you are not, because fair, you are not look good? Society. So all problems of society have become your problem. And in your house, there are three children and they make noise. Who will get the maximum attention? The crying baby gets the maximum attention. My in our house, there are two children, my daughter and my cousin's daughter. Okay. The cousin's daughter is naughty and she'll pinch my daughter and both will cry. Then you don't know who is crying, who is causing problem for whom. Right? So the society child makes a big noise and loud noise. So you think that you have a problem. Okay. The divine child is most silent. It is very peaceful. The divine child has no problem. Biological child has some problems. Of course, it wants food, hungry, it will cry. Okay. It wants to do pissing. It has some problem. It has some fever and some diseases. That's the problem of biological child. There are million problems for you, all because of society child. And you think it's all your problem. Who are you really? No, it's imposed, superimposed from divine child. Divine child is silent. So, who are you really? Are you the divine child or society child or biological child? This biological child, okay, this, see here, the biological child cannot survive without the divine child. The society child cannot survive without the divine child and biological child. So the divine child can survive anyway because they're from divine father and divine mother, consciousness, energy. It doesn't require anybody. So who are you really? Whose problem you are solving in your life? Who? Huh? Okay. All your life you are trying to solve the problem of this society child. Do you understand that? And Atma Adnana, all because of the society child. The divine child is always blissful. When the child is born, the child is called God actually. Your parents will say, God. You also say, the child is divine. Because the child comes with the bliss of the self, Atma, Shiva. Shiva is the self. The child has a bliss in his face. That's why anybody sees the child, they feel happy. Joy is there. But after you grow up, you become mess. The bliss is gone. Only mess is there. Why? Because of the society child. Now, entire Atma Jnana is understanding that I am not the society child, I am not the biological child, I am the divine child. This understanding and discrimination is called Atma Jnana. You don't have to become divine child, you are already divine child. Any questions? Is that clear?
Yes, this is a revision, Guruji. Last time you have done this.
You are there in the is this revision for all or is it revision? It is done.
In February class, we have done this.
No, Guruji, for us, okay. It is no.
Okay, some people are new. Okay, so any questions are there?
It is very good. It is a revision to understand properly.
Okay, divine child is a Sakshi, divine child is Chidabhasa, Chidabhasa is the Sakshi, Shiva. So, is this clear? So, all your problems are not your problems. It's the society problems. Atmajnana and Atmajnana also come in society.
So nice.
Huh? So Guruji, nice. Modi should solve all the problems.
So, Swapna, is it clear?
Yes, Guruji. But one thing, When we are thinking of Atmagnana, we remember that we are a divine child, but when we are completely involved in some other work, we forget. Why is that?
The crying baby gives more, gets more attention. The silent baby doesn't get attention. The divine child is a silent baby.
But every time, how do we practice to be a divine child?
So that's why this class is there. Shravana Manana Nididhyasa. Shravana Manana Nididhyasa.
Yeah, we are doing that, Guruji.
Okay. So, Lata, any questions? You have so many problems in life now, Lata?
The society fail has the problem, not me.
Okay. Okay. So, any question? Namit? Namit, you have a question?
Prabhuji, for example, if there are five children for a parent, is it like they have 15 children? Prabhuji means in Mahabharata, did Kunti had five children? Did she have 15 children?
No. See, actually, in reality, it's like that, but they don't know that. They don't come to this class now, Atmashana class now, they don't know, no?
Yeah, but Kunti may know, no, Prabhuji, it's common.
Kunti doesn't know, he doesn't come to Atmashana classes at all. Until you come to Atmashana class, you don't know.
Prabhuji, but in those days, it was very common, it was not a special thing, no, Prabhuji?
Yeah, maybe she knows.
Okay. And Prabhuji, in olden days also, was it like we should not tell anyone like we are Atman, or is it about the British history and all which we should not tell like we are Atman?
No, earlier days, since everybody knows, you can tell, but now nobody knows, no, everybody doesn't know anything, no?
Yeah, the Britishers, some people have forgot about their castes.
Yeah. So right now, because the society is like that, you cannot tell.
Yeah, it's situation based.
It's situation based, correct. Now, this society child is not one child actually. I told society child is only one. It is not one. It's a whole cell. Sometimes it becomes mother, sometimes it becomes wife, sometimes it becomes woman, sometimes beautiful woman, sometimes young woman. Okay, it's actually whole cell. It's multiple persons packed into one. So it's not even 3, it is not even 300, it's not even 3000, it's much larger. Are you clear?
So, Gurudeva,
yes, Sheetal.
Gurudeva, when right now the societal child, it has a role in the society.
So much give and take happens in the society.
Not able to hear. What is it?
Yeah, the societal child has so many roles in the society. Correct. As you said, it is not a one specific thing. There are so many societal imposed roles which right. it has to play. For example, when we say that Atmano Mokshaya Jagat Hitaya. This we have to, like, for the broader betterment of the society, taking context from the divine consciousness, we have to play the role, and we can always remember by playing the role properly that we are the divine child. So how to just join this, Gurudeva, just make it little bit clear. No,
thank no you. Question is not clear.
Yeah,
you have to make the question
clear. Is not. Yes, the question is, a societal child has many roles. To play these roles, by keeping the fact that, the truth that it's a divine consciousness, how it can be liberated from the clutches of the societal
divine child doesn't require liberation from the clutches of society child. Divine child is
no, 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 not the societal child. The societal child.
Oh, okay. Your question is how we play the role of the society child? How I can be still divine child, right?
Yes.
Now how many children you have, Sheetal?
One son.
So when you are talking to me, what is my relationship to you?
I'm talking as an divine consciousness with you. No other okay. relationship.
Yeah. Okay, no other relations.
No.
So when you are interacting with the society, do you remember that you are a mother of a child anytime? Do you forget that you are a mother of a child anytime?
No, I don't forget.
That's in the background, no?
Yeah.
That's the most important thing, no?
Yeah.
What is most important thing for you? I am the divine child. How can you forget that?
No, I'm not going to forget that. But I want to, use it efficiently when I am playing the role.
That's what I'm saying. If you are divine child, if you remember it, you will be very peaceful in any situation.
Yeah. I will know that, you know, this call has been taken by the divine child. I will know that.
No, I'm saying when you are divine child, you will not be perturbed by the society's turbulence. Your mind will be calm and peaceful. Then your decisions also will be proper.
Yes. Okay, Gurudeva.
Right?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yes, Gurudeva.
Anybody else has a question? Okay. So did I answer your question or you didn't answer your question?
Prabhuji, I have.
Wait. Yes, Shita. Complete the question.
Guruji, 1 minute.
1 minute. Shita, complete agle.
ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಹೊರಟೆ ಗುರು.
ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೆಟಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ,
ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ನೀವ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಡಿವೈನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೇನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು, ಇದನ್ನ ರೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರು
Yeah, it is very close. I can say that. Yeah.
So you define the question clearly then.
As I wanted to ask you that, you know, for example, I had to take a call. For example, that, you know, somebody had, I'll give a very specific, you know, I will give an incidence without taking any inferences from those. For example, if somebody is traveling in this condition, okay, thinking that, you know, somebody has passed off or something, passed away, and you know, this is not a situation, the situation outside does not permit anybody to travel, you know, outside the city. So the societal child in them is, you know, it got woke up in them actually. Then, you know, me knowing that, you know, getting perturbed in this situation is not a way. So the divine consciousness, which says that, you know, the emotions and all right now are, you know, temporary. If they are not addressed and they are told in a very specific way that how, you know, you can just delay the process of even thinking of going there, don't go there. And, you know, when I tell this, I know that this is for the betterment of the society. Then is this role, I am always remembering this, no Gurudeva. I am telling this because this is for the betterment of the society only, no.
Correct.
I know that. Correct. Yeah, that's what.
So when you are a divine child, your decisions will be more accurate and more uncluttered.
Yeah. So now you understood, right, the question right now. Yeah. So I got the answer. As you said, even Katayani ji she understood it very well as right now she said, ki, you know, when I take a decision based on the betterment of the society, even the societal child is, you know, always reflecting the divine consciousness, a divine child only.
Yeah.
Yes.
So the society child actually should be servant of the divine child.
Yes. Yes, Gurudeva.
Understand? Yes. Normally. But really, yes, really, society child dominates. A bully dominates.
Yes. 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 Yes, but it should not do like that. It should be very, you know, it should take the inferences from the divine child and it should be firm.
Yeah.
It should not be acting from the world's conditionings.
It should be based on the divine inputs.
Yes, Gurudeva. I got it. Thank you, Gurudeva.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you, Kataliji.
Where is Namit? Namit was asking some question.
Prabhuji here.
Yeah, right.
Prabhuji, does ego come in the group of society child or human child? Does ego comes in the human child? Does it come in the group of human child or rather what's that? Yeah,
ego is the society child.
Okay.
Okay. So shall we complete this?